fit for nothing fellow to be a political head or ruler of a nation. This is public demand. So public demand only creates mainstreaming. That public demand will rise. Public demand will rise on various issues like attraction, fascination, incentive, booster, prices, competition, everything, etc. Some mania is there. Most of the people practicing Ayurveda are going for Ayurveda. We can classify this thing into four types: beneficiaries of Ayurveda, and number two, maniacs of tradition. And third thing is somebody who is always jumping, who is an alternative amphibian. Such people, they are known as alternative amphibians. Anything that is new, they will get inside. As the allopathy was new, they got into that. Now as Ayurveda is replenished and reintroduced, it appears to be new. So anything that is Ayurvedic, natural, organic, herbal, now if you put these four names in any brand, even if it is a cow dung, people are ready to take. It is also a mania. So we have to understand, bad people are maniac. Bad people, those who have exhausted all of their hopes, they go for some solace. Those who are understanding that and going for that. So people with expectation, people with experience, people with hope and exhaustion, and people who will go just for fascination and craze. There are four people in Ayurveda, and don't think that Ayurveda widespread in the world that renounces this Ayurvedic demystification and that pronounces Ayurvedic victory. It is not like that. Most of the people practicing Ayurveda is a danger to Ayurveda, because if it is liberalized, lot of other fake companies will come. Lot of other fake practitioners will come. This thing going to foreign countries is not development. At the same time, we have to be very clear, even the Indian people, they are not able to follow that. So it will create lot of certifications, lot of other practitioners, wherein by the real genuinity of Ayurveda will be made debatable. So we have to be clear that while the things are widespread, while the things are made popular and familiar, at the time we have to be careful about the precision and value of practice, which is not there in Ayurveda. Somebody told there are 1,25,000, somebody in before 10 or 15 days, somebody told 1,25,000 yoga practitioners in Canada registered. So qualitatively, does it mention something about great about mystic achievement? It is not so. Most of the people, they may be asana teachers. They will be knowing about 10 or 12 asanas, by which at last they have been given the simhasana to sit in the teacher's seat. They are not clear about the mystic practices and fundamentals. So this is where we have to practice. Then public demand will come, really, number one. Whenever something is cheaper, free of cost, that is affordable. Number two, risk-free. Number three, preventive quality should be there. Number four, durable quality should be there. If you take the medicine should not make you to take it every week or every fortnight or every month. That should not develop a bondage, wife and husband bondage between the medicine and the patient. So it should have, number one, durability. If you take the medicine, at least it should immune the system so that you will not get it back for at least 6 months or 1 year. So they will go for something which is cheaper, that is affordable. Second, that which is risk-free. Third thing is that is preventive. Fourth thing, that is durable. Fifth thing, that is composite. That will not only cure the disease, that is greatness of Ayurveda. That will not only cure the disease. Number two, it will activate the inner dynamism so that such diseases will not be created, number one. Number two, it will also cure the connected diseases. That is the greatness of Ayurveda. So they will see whether it is composite in curing also, and also precision in diagnosis and perfection in treatment. These are all the expectations of public. So that which is having these qualities of affordability, risk-freeness or risk reduction, durability, preventability, composite curing, precision in diagnosis and perfection in treatment, that is going to be public demand. So we have to create this public demand competitively, comparatively. This is really mainstreaming Ayurveda. That is with three people. One is students. They should see that they represent the real Ayurveda. They should not represent the degree, but also the dignity of Ayurveda. Everybody is representing the degree of Ayurveda. If they represent the dignity of Ayurveda, certainly it will be there. It is in their hands. Number two, it is in the hands of the teachers. They should see that they develop good practitioners. For the examination, they are correcting something and writing as if it is history or geography. History and geography, it is okay. For example, if somebody says that my hand is shivering a little bit, it is okay. If the person is a clerk or accountant, it may not be a problem. If he is a neurosurgeon and the hands are moving like this as if he has to play some tabla or something, then it is very dangerous. So Ayurveda, that deals with life. You are playing with lives of people. So you must understand the seriousness of the subject and the same mucking up. You cannot deal everything with the same thing. You cannot deal with same thing. For example, science is entirely different, history geography is different, language and non-detail is different. Ayurveda should be read as a penance. It is a tapasya to read Ayurveda and just mugging up with physics, geography or various other studies, whether it is scientific or non-scientific, that is not applicable to Ayurveda at all, because you are understanding life. So you are understanding various other things. You are understanding geography by understanding the surface of earth, by understanding the celestial things and understanding constellations, understanding heat, magnetism. These things are entirely different. Understanding life functioning deficit, compensation, life extension and life saturation and solution. These are all the studies of Ayurveda. Life functioning deficit, replacement and extension of life. Extension of life, then life model, then solution and saturation. I have already told that now. So this is Ayurveda. So you must be more serious, sincere, because it is a sacred mission. But they have made only it as a secret mission by their own ismology and other things. They did not consider it to be sacred. So making it as a public demand is possible only by the scholars of Ayurveda, the students of Ayurveda, and dignity should be established by the pharmaceuticals by maintaining the ethicism in practice. That is known as pharmacoethics. They have to mention, also maintain the pharmacoethical standards to bring the dignity of Ayurveda. And it is the duty of each and every son of this land, each and every sage of this land, each and every scholars of this land, each and every pontiff of this land to safeguard the dignity of our religion, our studies and heritage, to see that these three people are properly doing our work. They have to watch that these three people should practically deal with all of these things. This is known as mainstreaming. Mainstreaming, we have to bring all of this. There are two problems. One, the composers of Ayurveda, analysts of Ayurveda, the invigilators of Ayurveda, commentators of Ayurveda, they are all pertaining to a different landscape, that is a different chronological state, a different way of living, different intellectual status, etc. See, just as we are reading about Sushruta, we cannot be Sushruta. You can write about Kumbhakarna, but can you be like Kumbhakarna? You can write about anything, 1 crore, 2 crore, 5 crore, you can write about anything. But you cannot have that stuff, you cannot have that stamina, you cannot have that stagmatism, it is very difficult. So the main problem is, Ayurveda was composed in a different area, in a different field, by different people who adopted a different style of life, who had a different intellectual status. Whenever we are going to bring the same, there is a lack of proper adaptability and compatibility where we are getting a mass cleavage. The proper people, the modern people approaching Ayurveda, they are not so specially talented. They are just kicking themselves for normal talents of going through the books and mastering these things, memorizing these things and writing an examination. That to come for this lamentable special talent. So that is the problem. The composers, that is the primogenitors of Ayurveda, as well as the novel identifiers of Ayurveda, now they have a vast value in between them and how to surpass these things. It is one question. And the other thing is, there are two things. One is mythological medicine. And second thing is medical medicine. Ayurveda consists of a lot of mythological works, wherein by Dadichi, his bones have been made into Vajrayuda, and King Vena was dead, and his thigh has been cloned, DNA from his thigh has been cloned to create Prithu Chakravarti. We have a lot of information in mythology.